Here's an interesting story, Lewis. Of course, everybody is aware of the Felix Baumgarten, Baumgartner. I guess it's called the Red Bull Stratos jump, also known as the record-setting stratosphere jump, where Felix Baumgartner went up in a balloon,
helium balloon,
and jumped from about 24 miles up. This is being considered a big deal by some, and it's also being considered nonsense by others. Here's a little bit of video of him in the free fall, where the parachute opens for our television audience. Let's take a look here. He's, of course, dropping here. And once he gets to the... There we go. The parachute opens. And he continues on down. I actually watched the entire video. It's a little bit repetitive at times, but certainly compelling. And then we also have a little bit of video here, Lewis, of the actual landing that took place, which is incredible, from 24 miles up to landing very, very softly. Take a look at this.
Got the highest jump mark that he was after. We'll find out about the Mach. Did he break the speed of sound as he hoped? Here he's coming. And there you can see by the approaching shadow, he's just about there, and he's down.
The first time he's a new world record holder.
So there it is, the big landing. So after a couple of failed attempts, it finally happened. I think this is cool, but then the question is, well, what's the value of this in terms of research? I mean, there are a lot of research purposes for this. Number one, quickly changing air pressurization when you're coming through. You know, that could be relevant in terms of commercial airline flights. What about life support systems for people who are very high up? Or what if you actually had to abort some kind of a space trip, could you possibly eject? I mean, I can think of a lot of different things, right?
Yeah, well, I think one of the biggest tests here was to possibly have someone land on another planet by jumping from the stratosphere or close to it, and not having an aircraft need to land on the planet, which, of course, would be a lot more expensive. There's
right.
a lot more involved when that happens. So, I think in the distant future, hopefully not too distant future, that could have practical applications as far as colonizing and landing on other planets.
Natan, your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I think the scientific applications are important, but also I think it's just as important, if not a lot more so, just the fact that, you know, 8 million people viewed this on YouTube Live, millions more are hearing about this. And this is the type of thing that gets kids interested in science. They start associating science with excitement, and they want to get into engineering, and they start to say, you know, I want to work for NASA. So this is exactly what a country where a significant chunk of the population doesn't believe in evolution and we're, you know, lagging behind green energy solutions to China, this is exactly the type of thing we need.
Absolutely agreed.
Good stuff.